Hi everybody, James here. I got another V9 robot build video to show you. I haven't posted a video in quite a while because I've been busy working on the robotic arm. And it's been a challenge, mainly because I've been trying to make it do an awful lot of things. Essentially what I'm building is a robotic arm that has 6 degrees of motion. Plus I'm trying to make it so that it will basically have an extension in and out of the torso of my goal was 18 to 20 inches. I ended up with about 16 inches. I hope I can live with that. It's a little shorter than I wanted. So basically this is the mechanism here. I've got everything working except for the slide mechanism. And so I don't have a motor hooked up to it right now, but basically it will slide in and out of the torso like that for the initial movement. And then right here, it's hard to see, but right here is a hinge I built. And eventually I'll have I've got a solenoid right in here that locks the forearm in position, but basically the forearm folds up right here. So what will happen is when I store it inside the torso, I'll lift the arm up, the elbow will turn in the opposite direction so it stays straight. I'll release this pin so that when it rotates up and this rotates the opposite direction, that will actually lift the arm or pull the rest of the forearm part into the torso even more. And then I do that opposite going down and basically move the elbow and the shoulder in opposite directions, and that causes it to come back out and then it locks in place. So the slide mechanism and the rotating of the folding of the arm inside the torso, I don't have working yet. I actually have another motor back here that actually rotates the entire arm. That's a rotator cuff. With that motion, I can actually make the arm not only go up and down, but it can go inward towards the chest and outward away from the chest. That works, but I don't have a strong enough servo back here for it to handle when everything gets turned to the side. It gets too much torque out there and it starts slipping. So I gotta come up with a stronger servo back there. But the rest of it works pretty well. So I'm gonna show you what it does. I've got a routine that allows me to put it in a downward position so I can assemble and disassemble it safely. And then a routine that starts up and puts it in the right configuration that's safe for it to move. And the key thing is, this motor here is runs the shoulder up and down, you know, like your normal shoulder works up and down, but it's a gear motor, not a servo, and it has an encoder in it. And because of that, it needs a homing position. So what I do is I put everything else in proper alignment, and then I give the initial command to move this motor, which initially puts it in the home position, which is straight up. So I'm gonna show you that movement right now. It's basically a starting routine. It'll put everything in right position, and then it'll move the arm upward, and I think it'll probably go out of picture as it moves up, but there you can see it moving up, and it'll hit the limit switch and then it stops in its upright position. Now again, when I get all the rest of the mechanism working, this will actually fold as it's moving up so that the claw will be sitting approximately right, about right here when it's in the closed or inside the torso position. But anyway, that's that movement. So I've got, again, 6 degrees of motion. So the 1 degree where I rotate the whole arm around, that's not powered up right now. Because again, that motor won't handle if I go sideways. It's actually powered up to hold it in position because it'll hold it this way okay. It's when I start going left or right or start rotating, it doesn't have enough torque and it starts slipping. So that's that. So now I'll put the arm in the normal horizontal position. There's one problem I have, I don't know why, but it takes a while for the initial movement of the shoulder motor to get started. Once I move it once, it works fine. Now again, once I slide this all the way out, right now I don't have it all the way out just because it puts too much torque on the back side of the mounting plate. But once I have it all the way out, I then could move the arm, the shoulder down as well as up. But right now, that's all the further I can go because I don't want to really put too much strain or have this way out. But it'll basically move, come all the way out, and then I can move the arm up and down. So that's the second degree of movement. First degree of movement is the rotating. Second degree is the shoulder moving up and down. The third degree is the elbow. So I can basically run it up and down. Right now I got everything set to move pretty slow. I can change speeds, but for right now I'm just basically got it in a fairly slow moving situation. So that's the third degree of motion. Fourth degree is moving the wrist back and forth. Again, I got it pretty slow, but you can see it moving there. Got some adjustments yet to do on it. I think I got a lot more room to be able to move when it's outside the torso. When it's back up against the torso, obviously can't move the wrist as far. But anyway, so that's the wrist movement. Then I can spin the claw around. So there it's spinning around. Again, I got them programmed to be really slow. But that's spinning around. I got pretty good motion on that one. I got plenty of room to have a lot of motion. So right now I've got it moving quite, to the extremes because I got the room there. There's nothing blocking, or running into anything, so I can move it pretty far. One other thing I've got is I've got all these wires laying all over the place, which I think is causing some interference because every once in a while the thing will just kind of jerk around, but for the most part it's working pretty good. Let's see here. 80s, where I'm going to go with that. All right, and then the last degree of movement is my jaws. So you can see I can open up to that wide and shut her down. So that's the 6 degrees of motion. Again, once I get the rotating part done, I'll be able to move, instead of just moving up and down like that, I'll be able to essentially move it this way because I can turn it so that the motor, servo motor, can then move the arm that way, move the wrist up and down because I rotate the whole thing. So I'll have a lot of areas to move once I get that rotation going. But anyway, that's the basics of my arm. And then I got one other routine that basically puts it down in a safe mode so I can turn the power off. So I do that. And it'll go put the arm in a safe position, and then basically let the servos power off, and so it's now in a low power mode. Again, when I get it actually working it in the torso, this won't be the final position. It'll obviously be inside the torso and sticking horizontal, so it'll stick out, but. Anyway, so that's pretty much all the movements. Again, 6 degrees of motion. So once I get started, it seems to be working pretty well. So I'll show you one more thing here, and then we'll finish up. I think I could show it to you. Yeah, I should be able to show it to you. I think I got it in position where I can do that. Yeah. So let me shut her down. So, let me turn the power off before I do this so I don't get my fingers caught into things. Let's do it this way. Go ahead and power the whole thing down and unplug it. Sorry for blocking the picture right now, but I gotta unplug the servos at least. I think I'll unplug everything. Battery unplugged. It'll actually drop down a little bit. Okay, so again, once this is all the way out, that's something new. I guess since I've been running it, it's a little weaker now. I used to not be able to move that by hand, but I guess there's enough torque in there now it can. So basically, I've got a solenoid right up in here, and I don't know if I can get to it with everything connected. Yeah, I don't think I can. I was going to show you how it folds up, but I can't get to it. Oh, well. Yeah, maybe I can. Can't. I don't have power hooked up to it, so I can't power it up and move the servo. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to do it, I don't think. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Well, almost had it. There we go. Oops, moved it the wrong way. Yeah, maybe I can get a screwdriver in there to keep it from hitting. Nah, not gonna be able to. One more try and I'll give up. There it is. So basically with that moved, you can see here that the forearm itself now bends as well as, or upper arm, not the forearm, but the upper arm bends in the middle. So I can't, I hate to turn that because I've had troubles with that. So I'm not gonna try to turn that by hand. I should have left it flat. But anyway, you can see that it'll break. So when this all slides back, and then I lift this up, it essentially breaks like this. So the upper arm is facing this way. The uppermost part of the upper arm half is this way. The rest of it comes down that way. And then the forearm is pulled in. So basically it does this number and gives me a lot more movement, I hope. And I'll show that in another video. But anyway, so that's my robotic arm. Hope you all enjoyed it.